Kajingkili balawan ra du MLA ke mauklang uba SK Sun halor kajingpelai deuyong nedu belakang daga National Green Tribunal kelawan ra kajingetietnya Mark Liang hapadeng umentri rangba kejela ukan rat ke sama bad unong ilam keliang persya u Dr. Mukul Sama hapok kayung darbar mentah kasingi kini kajingetietnya kelong halor kajingkini nam Mark Liang hapadeng kesarkar barim bala ilam lu Dr. Mukul Sama bat kini kesarkar bermentah bala ilam lu Konrad ke sama. Kat bau Dr. Mukul ulak kena bat kini kesarkar ke layak suki hak bau budin yang kejing pelat duyong hak jela. Kesarkar berim ke layak setiap bha kumnu banyakun yang kini kejing ia jeng kepej bak nak kejing syak kang ti duyong. Hendak yu Konrad ke sama ulapan pai niya kela yang kini kejing kam u Dr. Mukul sama hak bau ulong bahai kata kejing ia setiap kakam hak kesarkar berim. Ulong bahak kejing sisa kesarkar berim ke bala ilam lu Dr. Mukul kelayok po nadu usnam aja katsan hendai hadu usnam aja kat praru kam simkia ban pelat yu doyong ha ke jela bat kidon kisaki halor kene kediru ke jingja ke ba kamper ha ke ba ke wei ke jingkeli kala ne hadu san pusan minit ha ke kenta keli jingkeli ke bari ke por ha po sikenta siwai kene ha baju bab ke jingkeli jong MLA ke mau plang ba kwa ban tip la ke jingti doyong kliu kenai la pelat ne ha ke jela Meghalaya umentri rang ba ulong ba ka hukum ke Supreme Court ha ke laitrik benai naitung arja kat kendai kala kranchai bai kajingti duyong la banti ha kene jela hadi melayu ya kajingbit na ka mine and minerals development and regulation act kat kendai spa san penyo badru ka mineral concession rules kat kendai spa repo bad kumju kat kum ka coal mines regulation arja kat nyo bad ka environment protection act kat kendai spa prapun riu o menteri rang ba along ba kamlong ka bajam ban yo jingbit banti duyong klem da bot yiki kendon bala bot ka supreme court kamta maha ka bai dei ba ka jingya da ya ka mi mariang ulong ba ka hukum ka supreme court ka dei ka ba wandur bha namar ba ka sha ban ti doyong tang la da bot i ki kendon ban ya da ya ka mariang hendai ka wei ka ba pen kimen ni ka ba ka jela kat kum ka jingong menteri rang ba kalong ba ka supreme court ka lapen scam ya ka jinglong trai jong ki rulum halor ka kendo ka siap
these treasures of nature are for all generations to come and for intelligent use of the entire country the present generation owes a duty to preserve and conserve the natural resources of the nation so that it may be used in the best interest of coming generation as well as for the country as a whole. In this context, may I know from the Honorable Chief Minister the contention put forward by the state before the Honorable Supreme Court order on the matter, sir?
The particular issue that has been raised by the Honourable Member and obviously the preamble of the order that came out of the Supreme Court, I think is exactly what the government also is looking at. So the issue here that we face is how do we balance out between the economy and the ecology? And I think we understand that here we are looking at the issue of environment, the issue of natural resources, the issue of how we will manage these natural resources now and in the generations to come so that these resources which not only us but our future generations also have right to, how it will be balanced. And that is the reason why if you look at the entire the order that has come out, it is a very balanced order, I must say, and therefore it is respecting the rights of the tribals. It is respecting the fact that the ownership is with the tribals and with the land owners, and yet at the same time different laws that have been put in are there to ensure that all these activities of mining which are leading to economic activity, livelihood, revenue for the state is achieved, but at the same time it should not be done in an irresponsible manner.
Whether it is a fact that the Supreme Court in its judgment has relied heavily on the need to protect the environment and in the process has upheld in letter and spirit all actions taken by the NGT, asserting that the tribunal relied on several ground research including that of Dr. O.P. Singh of Nehu, which speaks of acid mine drainage amongst other environmental damages caused by the coal mining, including reports of the State Pollution Control Board.
This is exactly what our point is, and I think I would like to thank the Honourable Member for really understanding and really bringing out these issues which would allow the people to understand the balance of economy and ecology. And yes, I think the fact that there has been a lot of consideration on the environmental aspect, the Supreme Court has said that the soil and the subsoil belongs to the people, yet in order to conduct the mining, you must clear other, apart from other clearances and compliances, the Environmental Protection Act 1986 also has to be followed. So therefore, obviously, there has been a lot of stress on the environment.
Is it also a fact that the Supreme Court in its order concludes that there is nothing in the Sixth Schedule of the Constitution which in any manner exclude the applicability of MMDR Act 1957 in the tribal areas of Hill District of the state of Meghalaya?
That there are two factors or two issues that we're looking at. One is regarding the ownership of the coal and who owns this coal and who owns the land. And the second issue is a procedural issue of what are the preventions, precautions and compliances that you have to follow. So I think it is important not to mix the two. Now, what is happening here, sir, is that the fact that it's a Sixth Schedule area and the fact that we have got our tribal rights and certain ways and customary practices, based on that and the arguments which went on for hours and hours, you know, we got the order that says that Sixth Schedule areas have been respected. Respected in the sense that the ownership of the soil and the subsoil belongs to the landowner. That is where the respect to the tribals and to the Sixth Schedule has been given. But at the same time, keeping in mind the issues that were mentioned by the Honorable Member in his first question, that whether the environmental issues are important or not, therefore the MMDR Act, which requires mining plans to be put in into place, which have to be cleared by RQPs and other authorized agencies, is being mentioned. So therefore, yes, even in the Sixth Schedule area, though the ownership is not affected, but the procedure with which you will follow and do the mining has been prescribed by Government of India in order to take care of the issues which you had mentioned in your first point, which is the environment and other things like the safety of the miners. So this is the difference between the two.
Has taken enough time to reply. Enough time. In fact, the whole time is consumed by his narratives. It was not to the point. Now, let me come
sir,
to
I
the...
Sir, I think this is not correct.
No, it's very important. Let me put the question.
Hello to put this.
Let me put the
Number
question.
Number one, sir, the members have been saying that they want clarity. So it is my duty to give the clarity. And I think if I give clarity on
yes,
the issue, I don't think
that.
Comments like this should be made, sir.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, now replies to question number 52A. The reply indicates the status. Now, may I know from the Honorable CM in the first instance, with the judgment of this Honorable Supreme Court pertaining to this case, what is the status of Mines and Mineral Policy 2012 of the State Government?
Mines and Mineral Policy obviously is still applicable, but certain provisions, which of course I don't have details of right now, but the provisions accordingly will have to be adjusted. But then all this, the MMDR Act which we have will be applicable, sir.
Now, if it has to be applied in a modified form, whether state government has taken measures to expeditiously complete this exercise, keeping in mind illegalities going on all across the mining area, to ensure that legal mining starts. If you don't start legal mining, illegal mining will continue. Therefore, what measures in respect of if there is a need for modifying this Mines and Mineral Policy 2012 have been done? When was the meeting held to at least have this Mines and Mineral Policy amended, and what is the status?
Sir, we have been having multiple meetings. I can assure you.
No, specific to this, Mines and Mineral Policy.
Well, I don't have the exact date with me. There's so many things over there, sir. But I don't have the exact date with me, but we're moving very fast. I can assure the House, sir, that we're moving more expeditiously than the previous government, I can assure you.
See, this is very important, Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir. Even last night, there was a media in Assam hearing, showing in the electronic media, number of trucks dumping coal from Meghalaya. It's the same for the state, same for us. And that is there. There should be a response. Therefore, the timeline for ensuring that the legal mining starts becomes very, very important. Now, therefore, we can understand that no step has been taken for taking this corresponding action to facilitate expeditious mining. That is one what we can understand from the reply.
Sir, is
another one
give,
is pertaining to the reply
A. Out here, can I reply to his point, sir?
No,
can I,
that is not a
you
question.
Cannot, you cannot give a speech out here. So let me tell you specifically.
You have given speech.
You also gave speeches from here before.
Now let me refer
sir,
to
the point
A.
Is, sir, let him ask a question specifically. Let me tell you, if he is saying that what has been happening for the past 1 year, why isn't things been moving expeditiously? I want to ask, what happened in the last 5 years? Why didn't we move in the past 5 years expeditiously? When finally we have moved forward, I think everybody should be happy about it. But here, for some reason, if Honorable LO is saying that in the last a few days, all these things have been happening, I don't know what was happening in the last 5 years. Details can be given in the last 5 years what is happening. So therefore, I don't think it's incorrect for the Honorable LO to mention these kind of things when he himself realizes that in the last 5 years, he struggled to get this through. It's a tough situation. But then our government worked overtime and we were very firm, we were decisive, we went ahead, and finally we're in a position where things are finally coming in order. I think the Honorable LO as well as the opposition should understand this and work together to ensure that we can move forward, because it's not in the interest of individuals, but in the interest of the state and the people.
Whether it is mining lease or mining plan, you look at the para 130 of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court. It's very clear. That's why I am saying that this government is not serious to start legal mining. It wants to allow illegalities to happen because it suits their intent.
Sir, I think let's compare last 5 years and let's compare the last 1.5 years. I think we know whose intent was what. I don't have to say.
Mr.
Actions,
Deputy Speaker, sir, let
sir,
him reply
to
that para 130 related
he's not
judgment.
Allowing me to complete. Let
Please
me,
reply
let
to that.
I don't interfere in him when he's saying. I don't know why he's getting so frustrated about this. But the point is, sir, when he's questioning the government's intent, we can see clearly that in the last 5 years, nothing moved, nothing happened. There was no intention of the government.
I'll tell about that.
There was no intention of the government to move anything.
I'll tell about that.
But today, we have got a decisive victory out here, decisive order from the Supreme Court saying that we can move ahead with the mining provided the policies and the different rules are obtained. So I think this,
no,
the intent should
reply?
Not be clear.
I have put a reply, Mr. Speaker.
Sir, they have not asked for any questions.
I have said, in respect of this reply, I am saying that this reply is wrong. Is it a fact that this reply is wrong in view of the para 130 of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court?
Sir, the 130 para is not in front of me right now, but I've been very clear in my...
I'm giving you. You must be having
a fine. I've been very clear in my statement where I've said the mining lease, the approval has to be obtained from the state government and the approval has to be obtained from the center government. And once the state government gives the approval of and obtains, and these individuals obtain the approval, then only the lease can be executed. Now, sir, there are different aspects. Now, the LO is, of course, he might not be aware of all these facts, but there is a different aspect of the prospective, the mining plan, and the mining lease. So there are three different aspects, and these three different aspects have to be seen separately.
What was the stand of the union government, which was filed in the Honorable Supreme Court in the form of affidavit? That MMDR Act and Coal Mines Nationalization Act shall not apply in respect of Meghalaya in as far as coal mining and lignite is concerned. That is the offshoot of the work of our government at that point of time. And you messed it up. And you are asking questions.
Sir, let me again, since Honorable LO has put this question, that the order of the coal ministry to give the exemption from these two provisions was given in 2015. They had the opportunity to work till 2018, 3 years. Once that order came out in 2015, nothing happened. So who messed it up? Did we mess it up or you mess it up?
Ministry of Coal doesn't work alone. The whole stand of the government is not considered by only one particular ministry. That was the reason. Now, what was the reason why, after the affidavit was filed, why the government could not prevail upon this?
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, reply to state question 53, sir. A. Yes, sir, the gate is in existence. B, no, sir. C, sir, does not arise in view at B above. And D, sir, does not arise in view at B above.